Hello, and welcome to KDAB News, the monthly update for professionals working with Qt, C++, and 3D technologies. I'm Robert Brock, and in this edition, we'll mainly go over the latest news about Qt 6 Alpha and first beta release, what's new in Qt 6, announcements, and resources. Lately, the alpha and first beta version of Qt 6 were released, and Qt's chief architect Lars Noll gave an overview at Qt World Summit. There is a lot of news coming with Qt 6, and I'm happy to have KDAB's Giuseppe D'Angelo, who is also a Qt approver, to give us some insights. Hi, Giuseppe.
Hello, Robert. Thank you very much for having me, and also a warm welcome to our viewers on the KDAB TV channel.
Yes, indeed. The alpha and beta versions of Qt 6 came out recently. Have there been any surprises?
Yes, we have just published Qt 6.0 beta 1. That's the first beta. We are going to publish between now and December one beta every couple of weeks, give or take. We're aiming to have a release candidate around mid-November, and then the final release is still scheduled for December this year. So everything is pretty on track. There haven't been any, if you want, major surprises so far, and we expect to release 6.0 as promised.
Awesome. So everything's on track so far. Lars Noll spoke about Qt 6 in his keynote at Qt World Summit. Can you summarize briefly what else is new or important to know in Qt 6?
Okay, summarizing briefly what's new in Qt 6, that is a bit hard because there are so many new things happening in there. If you're really interested into knowing what's going on, I totally recommend watching Lars' keynote as soon as it's available. You can also watch, of course, my own keynote about Qt 6 that I presented at the Qt Desktop Days earlier this year. And there is also a series of blog posts that are out that are going to discuss the major changes, the major improvements all over the board. So we have new stuff happening in the foundational of layers of Qt, if you want. We're addressing a few issues that have been with us for quite some time. The idea is that Qt 6.0 is going to be a foundational release more than a feature release. We don't want to add too many features to it. Otherwise, we would wait too much time. Instead, what we're going to do is to establish good foundations to build upon and then actually deliver some pretty big new features in 6.1 and 6.2.
Wow. So already a lot for people to sink their teeth into. That's great. What advice would you give to people thinking about updating to Qt 6?
Yes, of course, if you're already having an application which is running on Qt 5, you are very interested about what is the upgrade path. So the intended upgrade path between Qt 5 and Qt 6 is going to look like this. You need to update to Qt 5.15, which is a long-term support release, and it's there, and that will be your first step. The second step is going to be to enable all the deprecation warnings that come with Qt. So along the last few years, we've started, if you want, deprecating some APIs, suggesting you to switch to better APIs that have been introduced in the meanwhile. And you need to do so because Qt 6.0 is actually going to drop these deprecated APIs. So how do you identify the pain points? Well, the idea is that upgrade to 5.15 first and solve any issue you may have there. Then you can enable deprecation warnings coming from Qt. If you want to know how, there is a blog post on mine that I've published a few years back. So go and check it out. We may leave a link for you in the video description. And once you enable these warnings, recompile your project, figure out if it's spitting out any warning during compilation, and of course, address them. At the same time, we're also doing something else, that is, you really want to upgrade at least to 5.15.2, which is not out yet. It's going to be out just before the Qt 6.0 release. And the idea is that in that release, we're going to put a lot of compatibility classes, compatibility helpers between Qt 5 and Qt 6 in order to minimize the disruption when you upgrade. But I want to emphasize something here, which is the upgrade process. We try to make it as smooth as possible. We don't want to break all the APIs just for the sake of it. That's going to cause pain for very little gain, for users at least. And so a lot of care is being put into minimizing the disruptions. Of course, there could always be something that we haven't figured out yet, we haven't predicted. So it's also very, very important, if you can, to test your own software with Qt 6 as soon as possible. Because, of course, if there is any major disruption that we have not, if you want, foreseen, then we get a chance to fix it before it's too late. So this is kind of a call to arms. Please test Qt 6 with your software. Please submit bug reports, because we need them. We need the feedback from the community in order to know if we're doing something wrong.
So turn on deprecation warnings and fix them, and then test, and get those bug reports sent in to you guys. And final question, will Qt 6 remain available under the open source license?
Whether Qt 6 will remain open source, that's not even a question. Qt 6 will be open source. In fact, there is going to be absolutely no license changes between Qt 5 and Qt 6. Qt 6 will still be available under this dual licensed model, while you have Qt under open source licenses like LGPL and Qt under a commercial license. So you get to choose just like you could choose in Qt 5.
Good news for all then. Thank you so much for that, Giuseppe.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you very much for having me. Take care and stay safe.
As just discussed, there are many aspects to take into account regarding Qt 6. Here is a short comprehension of Lars Noll's keynote at Qt 6 World Summit. So, as we just heard, the focus of the new version is on cleaning up the code base and architecture, improve the performance and assure compatibility with Qt 5. The core product will become smaller and more modular, which is aimed to support the core values. The further release roadmap looks like this. Qt 6 will be released in December, with 6.1 and 6.2 planned for first half and second half of 2021. Below the video, we've provided you with a bunch of links offering more detailed information on single aspects. Of course, I'll also keep you updated in the coming news editions. On to the announcements. From 12th to the 14th of November, Meeting C++ will take place. You can attend the conference online this year, which can be done by signing up through the link below. And from the 16th to the 21st of November, the Qt Days Italy will happen as a virtual event. You can book tickets via their site, also linked below. In our resources, there have been some minor releases for some useful tools developed by KDAB, namely KD Soap, KD Chart, and KD Report. KD Soap is a web service access package for Qt applications. KD Chart is a comprehensive business charting package with many different chart types and a large number of customization options. And KD Reports generates printable and exportable reports from code and from XML descriptions. Learn more about the tools in the links below. Last but not least, if you haven't noticed it yet, the recordings of Qt Desktop Days have been partially released on YouTube channel. They're being released a couple at a time, so if you haven't seen the talk you want yet, subscribe and hit the little bell to get a heads up when it's uploaded. Thanks for watching, stay safe, and feel free to share any feedback or questions below the video. See you next time.